Oh, we're driven, and we want to thank you for watching WLJC here in Beattyville, Kentucky. And call in, support this great ministry and these great folks. Amen. And such a great cause for folks that are trapped at home and they maybe can't make it out to a church or they're in a hospital. This is their church. This is the only message that they get to hear. And we just thank God for what Sister Margaret and this station has done. Tremendously has helped our ministry, and through this, God has opened a lot of doors. And from the bottom of our hearts, we thank this station, and we hope that you call in and support, whether it be by pledge or by prayer. Call this station and give them just a pat on the back and say, we appreciate you so much for what you're doing.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the hour of harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to our service tonight from our WLJC studios in Beattyville, Kentucky. We want to welcome each of you regardless of where you are or what you're doing. We hope that if you're working, you'll just put your work aside for a little bit and stay with us. Just sit down, relax, and enjoy some good music. We have a good group with us. Dottie has phone operators, and we're going to do our best to be an encouragement to you tonight. And one way that we know is always an encouragement is the few scriptures that we share, because the word never gets old or tired, and you always get strength from it. So for those of you that could not read today, you know, I just read usually a few verses to get you interested in reading for yourself and letting you see what's in there, and maybe a hunger will start that you will start reading for yourself, because it's really a spiritual growth thing if you can do it. All right, Psalms 62, this is one of the Psalms of David. He wrote so many good Psalms and we love them, every one. It says, truly my soul waiteth upon God, from him cometh my salvation. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be greatly moved. How long will you imagine mischief against a man? You shall be slain, all of you, as a bowing wall shall you be, and as a tottering fence. They only consult to cast him down from his highest. They delight in lies. They bless with their mouth, and they curse inwardly. My soul, wait thou only upon God, for my expectations is from him. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. In God is my salvation and my glory. The rock of my strength and my refuge is in God. Trust in him at all times, ye people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us. Surely men of low degree are vanity, and men of high degree are a lie, to be laid in the balance, and they are altogether lighter than vanity. Trust not in opposition, and become not vain in robbery. If riches increase, set not your heart upon them. God hath spoken once, twice have I heard this, that power belongeth unto God. Unto thee, O Lord, belongeth mercy, for thou renderest to every man according to his work. That's Psalm 62, 1 through 12 verses. So I hope that you have been able to read today for yourself. And if not, there's your little scripture to think about before you go to bed. All right. We want to remind you that if you did not get Pastor Fred Finley's address, we will have him put up the address now or in a minute when they can. But this month is his birthday month, and we're seeing how many cards that we can get sent to him because he is facing a real physical trial right now. He needs there's the address, be sure and write it down. Send him a birthday card and let him know that you appreciate him and his ministry, what it has meant to you. And Brother Fred is in desperate need of a kidney right now, or a healing from the Lord. You know, the Lord could heal him just instantly, but for whatever reason, he's not choosing to do that. But we need to let him know that we love him and respect his ministry and want to encourage him. And so all these birthday cards is going to give him something to do to occupy his time. And so he needs a lot of encouragement right now. So, and because he's on that dialysis machine at home 16 hours a day, and you know that's pretty hard to stay in the house that long every day. But you know, he's doing everything he can that the doctors are providing. But and if there's been a few people that have called and said they would like to donate him a kidney. And so if this is true, if you would, you know, there has to be a perfect match. And so we're not sure. They're in the process. The nurse is in the process now of screening those and ones that have made this offer. So if you're interested in this, let us know and we'll give you the phone number to get in touch with Brother Fred. And but you be sure and send him a good card. Let him know what he means to you and what his ministry has. Well, because you know, when someone's down, that's when they need encouragement. Don't wait till they get well and up, run around and say, oh, I should have said this or this. That's like saying all the nice things after somebody dies. We've all heard that. But if you got something nice to say and do, do it now. Don't put it off. All right, that's what we'd like for you to remember to help us do right now, is to pray for Brother Fred Finley. He's been in the ministry a long time, been helping us for over 35 years. And so we know him, and we know that he's lived what he's preached. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come to you. We thank you for your faithfulness that has worked through the lives of your ministers, your workers, your followers. We thank you, Lord, that you've always had a remnant of people, a group of people that has never bowed a knee to the enemy. But Lord, they've been faithful to you, and we thank you for that. And so now, Lord, we're asking you for a miracle for Brother Fred Finley and others that are in need of healing and so forth. But with his ministry and reaching so many people, he needs health, he needs strength. And so, Lord, we ask that this be resolved soon. We ask you now to bless our guests and our phone operators and those that will be calling that needs help. And Father, we're so thankful that you don't cut off our time when we talk to you a certain amount of time during the day. You don't tell us, well, our time is up. But Lord, we thank you that we can come to you and pour out our heart to you like the scripture said. And as we do that, we know that you hear and you answer prayer, and we thank you for that in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. Tonight, we're happy to have with us some folk that they have some CDs and a couple of DVDs and CDs. Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio from West Liberty, Kentucky. The phone number to get in touch with them, 606-743-2847. And they're from the Living Word Ministry. So right now, let's welcome Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio.
As I walk down the path of sin, side, his feet showed prints of nails. I knew this was the man who died to save my soul from hell. Then I reached out, took his hand, held it tight and foamed. Since I began to follow him, I found his love divine. Each day I'm walking in his step, for heaven is my goal. Oh, the world has lost a sinner now, but heaven's gained his soul.
Back in the 60s. And Sister Margaret, I want to tell you and all of our listening audience out there that it still holds true tonight. God does not forsake his people. If we're true to him, he's true to us. And I'm so glad to see almost a full studio here tonight. Good to see Sister Margaret back. Of course, we always enjoyed Bill and Sharon, but it's good when the boss is here, I call him, and Brother Don, and he's going to pick one with us a little later on. We got some guests, and Sister Margaret's going to read their name. It go way back in the 60s, or the 70s at least, up in Ohio when we were in that country, and she'll be reading their name. And we got some wonderful people up in the upper room to pray, and so call in tonight, and we'll enjoy it. Got Carter Bricky on the mandolin. Son number one on the steel, banjo, and dobro. Miss D on the upright bass. Lady Murray doing the vocals and a lot of talking. And my name is Ernest Carter. From the Lord many times, searching for something that I could not find. I couldn't see through the sun for the shine, but for like it is, Mary.
Well, I search for some answers. A reason was me. I turned to Jesus and he set me free. Think about it.
He never gave up believing in me. On trusting that someday I'd see. Love was the reason he died on the cross. I found my Jesus, but he wasn't lost. I found my Jesus, but he wasn't lost.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus.
I found Jesus and he wasn't even lost. And old Ernie Carter was lost way back in the 60s, but thanks to good praying mom and dad and a praying brother and two sisters, they just kept holding on to the Lord. And the Lord finally returned back to the old ways. Carol and Danny are in Ohio tonight, and usually he comes down and sits in with us. Loretta and Jim and my cousin Rex Carter and Bessie are listening in Fairborn, Ohio. And Billy and Dorothy Magantz. Billy calls me Sister Margaret, I guess, sometimes twice a week, and we have a good conversation. He is a faithful listener. The WLJC and your program, and he brags on you all the time, and the Lord keeps threatening the group that he's going to come over to Moorhead one night and take us out to dinner, but he's been saying that for what, two or three months. So Billy, this song we just sang is for you. May I ask over to Pike County, got J.R. Blackburn, used to work in the evangelistic of the R.A. West Evangelistic Singers and Association over around Pike County. I used to watch him on TV. And then his mother, and law, Virginia Tolson. You got something you want to say about these folks?
Well, she loves us so dearly. So, Virginia, Glory. This whole program is for you. We so appreciate your love for us. And, Virginia, the beautiful dinner you gave us earlier in the year, we thank you for that, your daughter and her husband. And we hope you enjoy the program, Virginia, and we do love you and appreciate all that you do for us from the depths of our heart. God bless you and keep you, and you are a strong woman of God. Thank you.
Old A.P. Carter, song entitled, Keep on the Sunny Side. Here is a dark and troubled side of life. There's a bright and sunny side too. Though we meet with the darkness of strife, the sunny side we also may view. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten all the way if we'll keep on the sunny side of life.
This ferry broke today, crushing hopes that we cherish so dear. Clouds and storms will in time pass away. The sun again will shine bright and clear. Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten all our way. It will keep on the sunny side of life. Let us meet with a song of hope each day. Though the moment be cloudy or fair, let us trust in our Savior each day to keep us everyone in His care.
Keep on the sunny side, always on the sunny side. Keep on the sunny side of life. It will help us every day. It will brighten all our way. It will keep on the sunny side of life. It will keep on the sunny side of life.
Teresa Manning, you keep looking on the other side of life. The sun's going to shine again for you. That's a promise. God's got everything under control, Teresa. For my daughter.
Carter, your daughter Dee told me, Ernest, that if you'll kick off more of your songs, that you can save some money. Dee, I'm going to try that on this. Jesus is His name. Town called Bethlehem many years ago. A king was born into the world, the Bible tells me so. He came to set the captive free in the hills of a holy land. And this is what he said, that I look as the Son of God. He cleansed the lepers and he raised the dead and he made the dumb to talk. And to the lame he spoke his word, take up thy bed and walk. I got it. Told how he walked along the shore of Galilee. The lame was made to walk again, and the dumb was made to speak. This was the greatest gift from God. He walked on earthly sod. And those who crucified him said, this was the Son of God. He cleansed the lepers and he raised the dead and he made the dumb to talk. And to the lame he spoke his word, take up thy bed and walk. Wait again, Carter. Oh, Jesus is his name. Let's send it up to the upper room. Cecil, I call him Jumping Jack lovingly. He knows I don't mean any ill will about that. He's up there along with Sister Dottie, and I don't know who all, but I saw those two climbing the stairs. In fact, Brother Cecil opened up for Sister Margaret and prayed for the group here before we went on the airwaves. So we'll send it up there and ask you all to call in, because they're up there and they're good prayer warriors. Mary, I know you got some dedications.
Okay, I've got so many, I'll just sort of have to break it down. First of all, I do prison ministry, and I'm ID chaplain at the prison at West Liberty and Sandy Hook. So all you men at West Liberty tonight, when I walk into my service, they say, we've been seeing you on television. I say, well, get to see us live tonight. So to all the gentlemen at West Liberty Prison, your chaplain ID says hello to you, and God bless you, and hope you enjoy the program. I'm so thankful that we have an opportunity to come up there and minister to you men. And we will see you the third Thursday night, which is this Thursday night, and the first Sunday night of the month. For you men that have watched the program and haven't came out to our service yet, we invite you to come out and be with us. And we truly glorify the Lord there and see people being healed and being set free. And we're thankful for that tonight, what we can do in the West Liberty Prison. And then we will be singing at a revival Tuesday night, September the 27th at 7 o'clock p.m. at Wallingford Christian Holiness Church, where Pastor Tom Redmond is the pastor. And that's at Wallingford Road, can't say it, in Wallingford, Kentucky. And they're starting a revival there Monday, September the 26th, and it's going through October the 2nd. So if you have any more details, call us, and we'll tell you all about it. That's revival. We'll be there September 27th at Wallingford Christian Holiness Church, Pastor Tom Redmond. And then Sunday morning, October the 2nd, we are going to be the Eagle Ministry Church in Wrigley, Kentucky, where Pastor Gary Ferguson is a pastor, October the 2nd. That's Sunday morning. Any more details, call us.
Mary, let me say this. Carter has recently become a member over there, and of course he's known the pastor, Gary Ferguson, for years. Will you tell the folks about it and when we're going to be there?
Yes, you're Mary, a member over there. October the 2nd, right, Mary? It's in Wrigley, Kentucky. Everybody come out and be with us.
Gary Ferguson, he goes to church there.
Yeah.
Okay. Mary singing a song about the old rich man and Lazarus. What a sad, poignant song this is. If I had known Jesus.
This is for all you men at West Liberty Chapel.
We read of a man with riches untold, who needed nothing, not silver or gold, while another man lay at the gate full of sores, wanting only the crumbs that fell to the floor. But if I had known Jesus, the rich man now says, I'd fed the beggar, gave him my mortal bread. But now it's too late for me to find. While the beggar found peace, he never found bread. So many today are straying in sin.
Friends, listen. Would you listen to words?
Refusing my Savior, refuse to come in, not thinking of Jesus, never stopping to pray. How sad at the judgment to hear them all say. But if I had known Jesus, my soul would be free. I know I would listen when he called to me. But now it's too late for me to find rest. If I had known Jesus, I'd give him my best. If I had known Jesus, I'd give him my best.
Me do my dedication, but I don't have them here handy. I know one thing we've got to send them out is to, we want to send them out. I don't know where they've got them at. I wasn't ready for that right here. Okay, I'll send them all to my Ministry Fashion customers, and then Stephanie Davis, the newspaper, that, and her mother Pauline, that so faithfully does things for us in the newspaper to advertise we're going to be on here. And I want to send this out to my sister-in-law, Barbara. She's married to my brother, Bobby. So Barbara and Bobby Kegley, she lost her sister last Thursday, and so they buried her yesterday. And so we want to send them our concern. They're watching tonight. And Jamie Skeens and her mother, Sandy, and Stanley Messer, and all the help at IGA Donut Shop, who makes donuts for us every so often. Gloria Day, that comes from West Liberty. And there's so many, many people that sees us on here and sing. And then all the girls from the different churches that's friends with me on Facebook. And if I'm a little bit rattled tonight, we had some uneasy things happen Thursday, and so my heart is heavy tonight for my old grandson. He's 25 years old, and so if I'm sort of scattered tonight, that's the reason. I'm greatly concerned for him, but I thank God that things may work out for him. But remember him in prayer. My grandson is 25 years old, and he's just going through some things, and I can't go into detail about it. So remember my grandson, Matthew. And
they're taking care of that upstairs in the upper room. That's what they do up there. And I know you're in sorrow tonight. Carter, you know a boy named Charles Fletcher. He's a bluegrass boy, and he's like me. He's getting up in years, and he's kind of slowing down. But he, over where he lives, I think over around Laurel, Indiana, or Mountain, Kentucky, in that general area. But he liked our theme song, and our son, number one, David, said, "Dad, we've sung that song for 40 years. Let's quit singing it." So about a month ago or so, we quit singing the theme song. But that's what Charlie Fletcher said he loved. And we're going to sing it for you, Brother Charlie and the Lord. It's
Golden Morning.
The Golden Morning.
Hey, 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 hey. That golden morning is fast approaching. Jesus soon will come to take his good and faithful children to their eternal home.
Oh, we see the gleam of that golden morning piercing through the night of gloom. Oh, we see the gleam of that golden morning that will burst the tomb.
I think I broke a pick here, or at least it twisted out of shape. But we'd like to do that also. Did we mention Roland Dunn?
Not yet.
We have another bluegrass boy. We were on reruns the other night, and I just settled down to watch it and got a phone call from a long-standing old-time bluegrass singer, Roland Dunn. And I was shocked to hear from him, but he said, "Ernest, I've been following you for years." And he said, "I know Carter Brickey and Carter's family," and he said he had kind of retired a little bit, but he wanted us to do him a song tonight. So, Roland Dunn, that song is for you. Okay, Carter, you're on.
Oh, okay.
Say something.
Summer's gone.
Summer's gone and winter's calling. trees are bare and the leaves have fallen. There's talk going around that God is dead, but I see God everywhere. I see God everywhere. Who made the grass to grow so small? Who made the trees to grow so tall? Who made the air that we love to breathe? My God, He made them all. Summer's gone and winter is calling. Trees are bare. There's talk going around that God is dead, but I see God everywhere. I see God gave the tear to the baby's eye? Who gave the gray to my daddy's hair? Who made the birds to fly so high? My God made them all. Summer's gone. Trees are bare and the leaves have fallen. There's talk going around that God is dead, but I see God everywhere. I see God everywhere. I see God.
Before you come on, we want to send that into the studio sound room. Sister Rhonda, we always rejoice when she's here because we can hear herself when she's at the control, not meaning that the others don't, but she likes bluegrass, I believe, and we appreciate her so very much. And you got a young lady here. I'm glad to see this. You're working young people and teaching them in the Lord's work and to do a good work, and their sound man, all the technicians. We love God's people.
Thank you. Well, we're glad Rhonda's doing a good job, then we'll hold her to that. All right, in the studio here, we do have visiting Charles and Irene Robinson from London, Kentucky. They came over to visit in the service, and we appreciate that. And so now you've been listening to Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio. And they have CDs, and then they also have some DVDs. And now these are really interesting because it tells the story of Ernest Carter and how the Bluegrass Trio sang. Now they brought us records to play way back in the beginning of WLJC radio days, and that was a long time ago. And so we've been playing songs by Ernest Carter for a long time, and so then they started coming. So, but they do have CDs if you'd like to order them, and the number to call is 606-743-2847. And they'll, that's the number to get in touch with them. We're glad to have all of them here in the Dobro and
Manland.
Yeah, and all of them doing a good job. And Steele. And so Don, he eats up good music. So I have no trouble keeping him happy up here when he likes the music. All right. We've got getting in a lot of calls and a lot of prayer requests, but we'll take care of those a little later. But right now, they're ready to do some more songs for us, and so let's return to Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio.
Sister Margaret, I wish I could hear what you were saying. You were saying some good things there, but age creeps up on you a little bit, and sometimes they overtake me, they overpower me. Carter's going to sing you another beautiful song. Carter, tell them what it is.
Okay. I want to say I'm glad to have my daughter here with us tonight playing. Glad to be here with David and, yeah, and B&E. And glad for Ernest here. He's been a very dear friend to me this past spring and really helped me out quite a bit. And also Landon, my son at home, he's wanting to take this mandolin. That's very mandolin right here, just as soon as I get done with the program tonight. And he says he's going to learn to play, so he better do it, hadn't he, Ernie? Here's one entitled, "You Only Pass This Way One Time." As we journey through this life, sorrow and strife, I set my hopes for heaven on high. Bear your brother's burdens and greet him with a smile, for we only pass this way one time. Be a friend to others, show a kindness every day. Rewards that he promised will be mine. Keep the faith he speaks of and praise him every day, for we only pass this way one time. There's a better home awaiting, and long to see the face of the friend who shed his blood for me and mine. Reach down and help another if he falls along the way, for we only pass this way one time. Judge another, no matter what the cause. By his grace, it could be you instead of him. Remember to be humble, Jesus judges right from wrong, for we only pass this way one time. At the end of my journey, what a blessing it will be to look back down the road where I have been, to see the deeds that I have done make a better life, for we only pass this way one time. There's a better home awaiting, and long to see the face of the friend who shed his blood for me and mine. Reach down and help another if he falls along the way, for we only pass this way one time.
Amen.
Sister Sharon, we want to send that song out to your good husband, Bill. And our heart's desire was to see him here tonight, but we understand the situation. And Bill, we're praying for you there in your home, and we go back many, many years, And we'll just continue on till the Lord calls us home, and then everything will be all right over there. May you have any dedication?
Not yet.
Okay. Son, do that pretty part on there I like. And tell Bill, he knows it, but we can live forever on the other side. When we're born, we enter into a world filled with sin. When we die, we live again. We can only believe.
And I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus. I can see the Lord.
Can't you just imagine living in His mansion, walking in His kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord?
The cross of Calvary, Jesus died for you and me. If we only believe in Him, you can live again, my friend. And I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus. See the Lord. Can't you just imagine living in a mansion, walking in His kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord? When our life on earth is through, we'll be judged by what we do.
Yes, we will.
And when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, that old grave can't hold me down. And I can live forever when I get to heaven. I can talk to Jesus. I can see the Lord. Can't you just imagine living in a mansion, walking in His kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord? Walking in His kingdom, the kingdom of the Lord.
I can live forever over in glory land.
Garden Angels.
Mary, we had you scheduled to sing. Someone wanted I.
We're going to do Love Me More and More.
Love Me More and More, but you're going to have to substitute that and tell them about it.
Okay, we're going to do Guardian Angel, and this was written by a young lady named Lori Milton. I think you know her, Sister Margaret. She used to come here a lot and sing. And for you, Lori Milton. So this goes out to you, Lori, and this is a song that she wrote called Guardian Angel. And I better send this out to some kids. My kids, David and Chris Beaker in Ohio, is listening. Sue and Burl Russell, Teresa and David, and Joshua and Kate. And Teresa, things are going to get better. And God is going to visit Matthew when he least suspects. He's going to show up at his side and touch his heart and deliver him and set him free. Amen? You're glad of that tonight? God's able to do those things. Thank you, Jesus. He's my guardian angel tonight, and He's my kid's guardian angel. Thank you, Jesus. seemed I feel the brush of an angel's sing hovering over me. Seems I hear the sound of an angel's sing, guardian angel watching over me. Watching every move I make, watching every step I take, protecting me from harm's way. My dear Lord, send an angel to watch over me. Praise God for this angel I can see. When times get tough and I feel so tired, the troubles, they trouble my mind. God sends an angel to watch over me, protect me and be by my side.
Watching every move I make, watching every step I take, protecting me from harm's way.
My dear Lord, send an angel to watch over me.
Praise God for this angel I can see. Praise God for the
angel I can see. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
All right, I want to, this will be probably my last dedications, and I like to get them under my belt, and then you can feel free to. Seems like to sing better. Son number one, we got through our hay crop, what, last week. Son number one is out in the field on the old tractor. Son number two was out in the field on the tractor. And son number three was out in the fields in the tractor. And, of course, I was there. We laid that by. And yesterday, we got to sell our crop of calves. We're not advertising, Sister Margaret. We're just telling you about some good people that come and buys every year for our cash, Tom and Nick, the Pico brothers of Moorhead. And they watch this program, and their sister, Eileen, calls them and tells them when we're going to be on, and they watch us religiously. And Tom is the one that I've been requesting prayer for several months now, that he would get a kidney transplant, dialysis. Last week he thought sure it was a coming up. So the Lord is moving in his favor, and he feels good about it. And he's trusting next week that maybe it'll come so. But anyway, I told the folks last time that for Tom to borrow from his sister Margaret, who runs a fruit market over there, to borrow some money from her, because we had a big crop of calves, didn't we? Mighty big. And sure enough, I don't know where he got it, whether he got it from his sister or the Bank of Baltimore. He had a stack of money that high. And time he got through with us, we didn't get it all, but we got it whittled way down. They're just good people. And after he paid us there, sister, he brought out from his sister's market there on Route 32 in Moorhead a big bushel basket of fresh fruit. And I distributed among all the group. Maybe you didn't get any of it, but I got some saved back for you. So for those fine people, I want to send this whole program out to, and they listen in also over there in Moorhead.
Visions of Mother.
Okay. Have we got it right? I met a man in D.
No, I visions of Mother.
Not calling on the phone to say come along, for I'm not going out tonight to drink and honky-tonk. I've served old Satan all my life, bound in sin and shame. I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name.
Jesus is his name. I met a man the other night, my whole life has been changed.
That's why I called you on the phone to tell you this one thing.
I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name.
For you, Matthew. I was passing by a country church, just a few in sight. There no one knew me, I knew no one, so thought I'd stop a while. Oh, there I heard this preacher say that Jesus died for me. And for the vilest sinner, he died on Calvary. So tell my friends and all my pals just what I'm telling you. I met a man the other night, he started my life anew. That's why I'm calling on the phone, tell you just one thing. I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name. I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name. I met a man the other night, my whole life has been changed. That's why I'm calling on the phone, tell you just one thing. I met a man the other night, and Jesus is his name. Do you all introduce this man? King Jesus is his name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I met a man.
Amen.
Can you sing another one?
Thank you, Jesus.
Okay.
Thank you, Father. Thank you,
okay,
Jesus.
Okay, he's moved to another town, and we didn't get together before we come on. So let's go up and do a mother song, okay? And B. All the good mothers out there, I remember my mama. All of my thoughts drift back to childhood, to the time when I was free, as I played before the fireside around my darling mother's knee.
Then one day our mother, Daddy said she's gone to rest. Oh, how I miss my darling mother as she clutched me to her breast. There's a blessed home up yonder, where my love once waited for me. I saw mother in a vision, kneeling there to pray for me.
know someday I'll meet my mother, a little girl is coming home to see her then, as days of childhood, the one she loved but left alone.
There's a bliss
at home up yonder,
where my love once waited for me. I saw mother in a vision,
kneeling there to pray for me.
Whoa, Mama, we'll meet you over on the Golden Shore on that glad morning. You want to get your banjo or you want to do another one? We're going to work him like we're going to Don in this little bit. I can't see the clock, but how much time we got?
It's about 10 after 6.
How much we got?
I don't know, 10 minutes.
Got 10 minutes, okay.
I guess we're going to do John the Baptist. I got to send this out to Brother and Sister Fields. He loves this song, so this is for you, Brother Fields. And I just love to brag, Sister Margaret. Are you catching up with me yet? I'm about to get my 15th great-grandbaby. Now, can you beat me? 18? Oh, she beat me. You got 18 great? Oh, well, I got 14 grand and 14 great right now. I'm getting ready to get my 15th great. Okay, we're even, almost even. Tell my age here, won't I? Okay, John the Baptist. For my grandchildren. Who was a bitter man, the Sampapa? Preached by the river all the while. A man with the volume of a moose, warning his hearers to get loose from the devil, John the Baptist. He could have been a general or some nation's king. He spoke with great authority, his truth bends hard to sting. He dressed himself in camel skin, locusts did exist, and he proudly wore the name John the Baptist. Born of a woman much too old, daddy lost his peace, no doubt we're told. Warning all Israel to repent, for right or Messiah he was sent. Preach the kingdom, John the Baptist. He could have been a general or some nation's king. He spoke with great authority, his truth men's heart did sing. He dressed himself in camel skin, locusts did exist, and he proudly wore the name John the Baptist. Spoke to a ruler very bold, words about his wife that knocked him cold. She was never satisfied until the voice of that preaching man was still by beheading John the Baptist. He could have been a general or some nation's king. He spoke with great authority, his truth men's hearts to sting. He dressed himself in camel skin, locusts did exist, and he proudly wore the name John the Baptist.
That's for you folks who love banjo picking and Mary about the great man. In fact, Lord himself said none greater in the kingdom than John the Baptist. Bill Kincaid, I'm going to do you that song. You're not here to request it, but it's a song that we always do for you. And do it for Don. And Don, while I'm doing this, if you'll come up, we want to back you to back us up on the next one. I'll pay you. We'll chip in and pay you.
He's been wanting to play with him for a long time. Come on up, play with him.
All right. Sister Margaret, you'll let him pick with us, won't you? Come on, Don. We'll not. There you go. I go to sleep sitting around too whenever they're singing a sad song. We love you, Don.
He's a joker. He's something else, Sister Margaret.
It's all about that dreadful Civil War that my great-great-grandfather fought in, and Dad never let us forget the exploits that he made. And for way up in the 40s, they still remembered the old South. It's gone, and I don't know who was right, but it was wrong for all the people to have to lose their life like that. Son, give me the taps. In a dreary Yankee prison, where the rebel soldier lay, by his side stood a preacher, every soul should pass away, and he faintly whispered parson as he touched him by the hand. Oh, parson, tell me quickly, will my soul pass through the Southland? Southland, through all Virginia grand, will I see the fields of Georgia and the green fields of Alabama? Will I see that little church house where I pledge my heart and hand? Oh, parson, tell me quickly, will my soul pass through the Southland? Southland. And then the rebel soldier died. Come on, Dan. One more, and I think they've gone to sleep on me up here, Sister Margaret. And I can understand it. They're all working boys, and we haven't been on the road that much, so I know it's their job to. All right, let's put Don to work. This will be our final song. Well, it takes a lot of loving to get to heaven, for love makes the world go round. If you shun your neighbor, then fail to love him, the Lord may turn you down. It takes a lot of loving to move to that mansion prepared for us above. Well, every time you can, let's stop and take a hand and stay in the spirit of love. If you would be a Christian, you must love everybody, wear a sunny smile each day, and wave and hide the banner of a Christian soldier, helping someone on life's way. You get from God a blessing when you walk in the Spirit, led by the Savior's hand. Well, that is your reward when you're trusting in the Lord and have love for your fellow man. One more time, Don. Get to heaven. That's God's love, not Hollywood.
Amen.
Thank you,
Donna. All right. Thank you so much, Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio. Remember, they have CDs and DVDs, the story and musical journey of Ernest Carter. You may order these DVDs, part one, part two, and it tells you a lot about that. You will enjoy that. And then, of course, they have some CDs if you'd like them. They have some the popular songs on here that you would like. And the phone number is 606-743-2847. And we appreciate them all coming and working hard tonight. And that is great. Well, we have a real good report here. Thelma from Scott County is 74 years of age, and she gave her heart to the Lord tonight. So that's our salvation report. So that is, as you see the cross go up, that's what it's about. We have such a big handful of requests. I've been reading over them, and so we will get as many as we can. From Covington, Kentucky, Faye is very sick. Lois from Wolfe County has breast cancer, had her first treatment today. Noah from West Liberty, Marlo from Perry County, and I'm not sure where that one's from, Williamsburg, Montgomery County, and they wanted Fred's address again, and that's 257 Sugar Camp Road, Jackson, Kentucky. So be sure and send him not a Christmas card. Well, go ahead and send him one if you want to, but a birthday card. He's having a birthday this month. Glenn wants all of his family prayed for. And from Jasmine County, from Berea. This one is from Powell County. Someone else having kidney problems. From Madison County, allergy problems. Carolyn for Vicky that's in the UK hospital. And this one from Montgomery County. Some folk that call in quite a bit, Golden Earl. And we have a great aunt from Woodford County, cancer for a great niece that's very sick. She has cancer and two little children. And we have another one from Pike County, blood clot center lung, Joan from Fred from Lee County. I had wanted a song request. Karen from Clay County for her dad sick. Madison County for a nephew. Madison County for two sons. Knox County, a son that's in rehab. From Pike County, Jim has cancer, an unspoken request for someone else. Eunice from Naples, Florida, for some folk down there that's in need. And this one is from Pike County, from Russell County, wants to wish Gladys Dennis a happy birthday. She's 88 today. From the state of Missouri, Madison has brain cancer, 15 years old. And another one from Madison County, another one from Pike County, from Rockcastle County, from Jasmine County, and from Madison. And we have a Diane that from Berea that's real sick. And a lady loves WLJC. She gets a real blessing, watches all the time. And she don't know what she would do without WLJC. That's from Floyd County. A couple from Monticello is celebrating their 65th wedding anniversary, but someone forgot to get the names of them, so you know who you are. So that's a big number, 65 years of married life. Here's Thelma from McCreary County. Here's a call all the way from New York for James that needs prayer. From Pulaski County, Lee Bingham having a 92nd birthday. Virginia from Pike County enjoying the Carters, and to pray for her. Deanna from Carter County needs prayer tonight. And from Fayette County, some folk that are praying for everyone. And here's Patsy, heart trouble, and a daughter-in-law from someone else in Whitley County. And we're not near through, but we're going to have to stop and pray for these. And so we invite you to join with us now, because there's a lot of needs in here and a lot we didn't get to. Some are having surgery. Some are just getting over it. Some are just needing a lot of other needs, a lot of needs. But we're thankful to hear from all of you. So let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, as we bring these to you, you already know about them, but our job is to present them to you, and we want to do that right now, Father. We ask you in the name of Jesus to touch and to heal and to set free and to save these people that needs it, and set free those that are in bondage, those that are in rehab. Give them strength to overcome their addictions. And Lord, we ask you to have mercy on our nation. Help us to stay a free country. And Lord, have mercy on the upcoming election and everyone that is elected to any office. Lord, we ask that they be God-fearing people to where that this nation can once again get back where it should be. Bless each person that has spent this time with us, and we thank you in advance, Lord, for answered prayer. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, we appreciate once again the folk for coming. Ernest Carter and the Bluegrass Hymn Trio from West Liberty, Kentucky. I don't know if I even told you where this from, but I guess you all probably already knew it. But anyway, all of you that called and spent this time with us, we appreciate it. And so just pray for the ministry. We have their fall revival and telethon coming up, and that's always a special time around here. So from all of us here in the studio, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy. And it's free. May God bless you.
Mercy and grace.